Back in July, a report from the U.S. Agriculture Department forecasts a slowdown in the growth of the Philippine food and beverage industry. But the Figueroa Coffee Group is proving otherwise as it plans to open stores in at least 8 provinces by year end. Let's talk about Figueroa's expansion plans and the Philippine F&B industry with Justin Liu, Executive Director and Chair of the Figueroa Coffee Group. Justin, thank you very much for joining us here on a Friday before a long weekend.
Thank you for having me, Ron.
Okay, most of the numbers looking up for FCG, 75% up in revenues for fiscal year ending June 2023, 155% up for net income. What are you attributing this growth to?
Actually, our growth is really attributed to high quality of products, strong consumer demand in the Philippines, and of course, our very beloved brands, Figueroa Coffee, Angel's Pizza, Tien Mas, and everyone just basically going out and eating more.
Okay, from the brands that you mentioned, it looks like FCG is leaning more on Angel's Pizza now. You've tripled the store count just from 2021 to mid-2023, and it now accounts for almost 60% of your stores across all brands. So safe to assume, and as you said, it's the one that's driving up sales, right?
Yes, yes. You know, actually in 2019, we only had 14 Angel's Pizza stores. Whoa. And now we have over 110 stores and a lot more under construction.
Were you surprised by its rise and how people are demanding for it?
Actually, you know, what, couple of years ago before the pandemic, Angel's was a very small brand, and Figueroa was really our flagship brand.
Of course, yeah.
Angel's had less than 15 stores before the pandemic, and our stores were located in hidden areas, but we had a lot of loyal customers. But during the pandemic, pizza delivery became really strong. That's when we also introduced our creamy spinach dip, and then everything just went viral and went from there.
I'm curious about that flavor. What made you bet on the creamy spinach dip? I was interested about it because I didn't think that a lot of people I like it. I didn't think that a lot of other people would, but what made you so sure about that flavor?
Yeah, actually, that's very interesting because when I first thought about that, I was thinking of, you know, I've been a pizza lover since I was a kid, right? And I order from all the pizza brands, Shakey's, Domino's, Pizza Hut. My family would always go for pizza family lunches every Sunday. And then when we got into the pizza business, I thought, how do we make a flavor that's a bit innovative, something different? And how can we introduce vegetable in pizza? So we experimented with kangkong, with different vegetables, then spinach. Then we thought of grinding it, but it tasted too vegetably.
Yeah.
And then our chefs thought, okay, let's add some cream cheese, some onions. And then it became that ball.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's presented in the balls on the slices, right? But very interestingly, during the pandemic, our customers were the ones who thought
spreading it out.
Yeah, on TikTok. So we didn't even think about that. And then when we saw that, oh, this is a great way of eating it.
The pandemic brought its rise, but how are you planning to sustain it in the next few years, most especially that you're betting on Angel's Pizza by putting up more stores?
Yes. So again, and now we have over 100 stores. Actually, if you look at our competitors and the large major pizza players in the Philippines, they have over 300 stores and they're really nationwide. Some have presence outside the Philippines. Angel's is really still scratching the surface. We are in the major cities, but we are not in the second or third tier cities yet. And we have very little presence in the malls, but we are growing slowly.
Okay, now let's go back to FCG. At the start of the year, the group had an infusion of $820 million with Mondelez coming in. How has that buy-in benefited the strategy of FCG so far, and what has Mondinisin brought into the strategy?
Yes, so actually we, a bit before Mondinisin's investment, we went public. So right. We raised about 700 million pesos.
Yeah.
This money was already utilized in digitalization, store expansion, building our commissaries, and then Mondinisin came in. So we have enough capital for this year and next year. We're looking to develop some innovative products with Monde. Monde also has a very strong distribution network around the Philippines. And you know, they have roots in Indonesia and outside of the Philippines as well, in different parts of Asia.
Yeah.
So I think it could be a possibility that we also want to branch out outside the Philippines in the future.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you mentioned about the IPO. We have Mondinisin buying in, but despite that, and aside from that infusion, you still want to open up FCG to outside investors, even if it means reducing the effective ownership of current stockholders. Why is that?
Yes. So as I mentioned, when we went public, we raised some money, but we have already utilized that. So Mondinisin's funds, which they invested, which they bought in 15% of the company, we will be using that for more store expansion. We have a lot of stores in the pipeline for next year. And we want to ensure that we have enough capital to grow 2024 and beyond.
Mm.
So as you...
Looking that far ahead.
Yes, and you know, we only have total of 193 stores right now, combination of all of our
all
brands.
The brands. Mm-hmm.
So there's still so much room to grow, and we want to, you know, this market with rising interest rates, the stock market is a bit uncertain with the wars going on, inflation.
Yeah.
We want to make sure that 5 years from now, we already have set funds for our growth and stability.
Justin, taking on new investors could be risky for some, of course. With new people coming in, there may be some shifts in priority, changes in strategy. Aren't you concerned about that? Or how are you going to ensure that your vision for the Figaro Coffee Group will remain despite new people coming in?
That's a good question, but I think that's not really a big problem, because in our latest board meeting, we only approved potential investment of up to 20%.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we will still be controlling the company through ownership and also through our preferred shares. And I'm sure that any investor who would want to come in would want to leave the management the way it is, or complement it by their strengths, because we have shown a very strong track record.
Let's talk about expansion plans. What's in the lineup for FCG in the next years?
So next year, we're looking to open more around Visayas, Mindanao, second and third tier cities. We're still focused more on Angel's Pizza, but we are selectively opening Figaro and Tienma in selective cities. We hope to open around 40 to 80 stores next year, depending on market conditions, depending on inflation. And, you know, there's a lot of room for expansion, but we're very picky with locations and franchisees.
And what do you look for in locations and franchisees?
So with locations, you know, most of our stores are not in malls.
Yes.
We are mostly outside malls to ensure our sales per rent per square meter is optimized. Our stores for Angel's Pizza are also targeted to operate 24/7. So it's
I do know that some of your stores are located in communities.
Yes, yes. Inside the dens, where the people live.
Yeah.
So that's one of our secrets.
with so many other restaurants, there's so many competition. It's like people are putting up restaurants every minute here in this country, and a lot of people haven't tried a lot of the new ones. And some of them are very similar to yours. Mm. How do you keep your edge over those new competitors?
That's a very fair question, because you know, during the pandemic and right after everything loosened up, we saw a plethora of pizza restaurants opening, mm-hmm. because they saw our success.
Yeah.
And the truth is, it's easy to make restaurants. Anyone can set up a restaurant, but the system behind the restaurant and the operational efficiencies and the digitalization that you have to put in place and management of staff is very, very difficult. So you can open one or two, but it's very hard to scale. Mm-hmm. And now with the rising cost of ingredients, inflation, each restaurant food F&B business needs scale to make it very profitable.
You're mentioning cost of the ingredients. Has FCG raised prices in your brands?
Yes, we raised prices slightly this mm-hmm. year to temper the offset inflation a bit.
How do you keep that balance? I do know that your website says that you believe in great products and experiences should be available to all and not only as a luxury.
Yes.
How do you keep your prices within reach but still carry the momentum of earnings?
So first of all, we need to analyze and compare ourselves against competitors. And right now, we are very proud to say that among all of the major brands, we are still the most affordable. And whenever there are price increases, these are very slight price increases just to slightly offset the cost. So we also improve our cost efficiency by improving our operations, and that's where we get some of our margins as well.
Final question, Justin. Aside from your expansion plans, what can the public and even investors expect from FCG in the next few years?
More exciting, innovative products. We're very excited. I have a lot of things, too many things in mind. Difficult to execute all at the same time. More fun stuff on our app, digitalization. Just a lot of exciting things.
Okay, we'll just wait for that. Justin, thank you very much.
Thank you, Ron.